DeltaV Mobile is a mobile application for iOS and Android devices that brings your operations data to your fingertips. One of the app's features is sending notifications to users via SMS, email, or push. Many times, users might prefer to create an escalation path depending on the severity of the process condition. Let's walk through the process of creating an escalation path for DeltaV Mobile. Log in to DeltaV Mobile Studio from your web browser. The URL is dependent on your mobile server address. Please contact your system administrator if you don't know your username or password. Open the alarm list containing the alarms for which you want to modify the escalation path. In the Users tab, select the first user you want to modify. In this example, Ben will be the first user on the escalation path who receives the initial notification. Bert also wants to be notified, but only if the problem isn't fixed within a reasonable time. Let's review the first selection options for alarm notifications. Under States and Priority, we will be selecting the kinds of alarms for which users will be notified. Initial notification state allows you to choose the state of alarms for which you will receive notifications. For example, you can be notified when the alarm is initially active, but the operator has not yet acknowledged it. Your options are active, unacknowledged alarms, active, acknowledged alarms, inactive, unacknowledged alarms, shelved alarms, or out-of-service alarms. State change notification allows you to configure further notification states for these alarms. For example, you can be notified when the alarm is acknowledged by the operator or placed out of service. Priority limit lets you configure the lowest level priority for which you will receive notifications on this alarm list. The timer section is where we will create alarm escalation paths using the variables delay, frequency, and max resend. Delay is the amount of time that the notification conditions must be true before a notification is sent. This can be used to give the operator or process a chance to correct the alarm without notifying you. In this example, we will leave Ben's delay blank. Frequency is used to create a reminder notification. In this example, we will remind Ben every 5 minutes that the alarm condition is still active. We can also limit the number of reminder notifications using the max resend entry. Ben's supervisor, Bert, wants to be notified if these alarms remain active and unacknowledged for more than 30 minutes. To summarize this example, Ben will receive an initial notification once the alarm is active. Bert will not. Ben will be reminded every 5 minutes with another notification until the condition clears. If after 30 minutes the alarm is still active, then Bert will receive his first notification. Make sure to select Save and Publish so that your alarm notification configurations are applied. Once you receive the alarm notification on your mobile device, you can tap it to open DeltaV Mobile. When you're viewing the alarm details, you can claim the alarm to stop the escalation path and let other users know you're aware of the issue.